Hi, everyone. This is the SMC Journal podcast. I am Scott Moore, your host. Thank you so much for joining me. Typically, we are talking about software engineering. Today, we're going to do something a little bit different and talk about the stuff the software runs on, which is hardware. Many of you are geeks like me, and you have your own home lab, and the home lab is always evolving and always getting expanding into new areas. And that's what's happening to me right now. So I want to share a few videos on this podcast about my journey as I upgrade my home lab and some stuff that has come up since I started upgrading. One of the things I'm going to be doing is changing over several of my pieces of network gear to Peplink gear, and that includes switches and routers and some different things. And for mobile, I'm definitely using Peplink stuff when I'm on the road for redundant multiple cellular connectivity, unbreakable internet. And I work with West Networks out of Gainesville, Florida, for a lot of this. They're one of the number one resellers for Peplink, support providers for Peplink. So I had a relative contact me and said, Scott, I have Starlink, and it's great for just having Wi-Fi access, but I'd like to add a router to that that will allow me physical Cat5 connections, cable connections from a NAS device, a network attached server. I want to plug a computer up into it that I don't want to be wireless, but I still want Wi-Fi and wireless access point with Starlink. Can I do that? And hey, by the way, I kind of would like to have something in addition to Starlink that I could use when Starlink kind of goes down in a bad storm when it's cloudy, or the bandwidth gets kind of bad at night, certain times when I'm fighting with other people. And I thought about this and I said, well, you need a multi-WAN router and access point, not just the standard one you would go from to the big package stores and just buy off the shelf or buy it on Amazon.com. So I started thinking about, does Peplink have something like this that would fit the small business home office type user with Starlink, for example? And it turns out Peplink has just released, just a few days ago, a couple of weeks now, the B1. And I want to show you what that looks like. Here's a picture of the front of this. And we're going to go into the specs of it. I'm not going to go too deep because there's plenty of videos out there that will walk you through all of this. But when I thought about this, it sounded too good to be true for the price point. So we're looking at the B1 at a $299 price point with two Ethernet WAN connections, four Ethernet LAN connections, all gigabit Ethernet, two antennas. So you've got two dual band Wi-Fi 6. So it acts as a Wi-Fi access point. It has an easy integration with Starlink, which was really what I needed. And then you can load balance multiple Starlinks. You could, you'd have one Comcast and one Starlink, and you could actually add in 5G LTE if you wanted to. Now, it doesn't have that built into the unit. That's one of the ways they're keeping the price point low for this, but you can expand into that. And one way you could do that is there is a USB connector on the front of this machine, and you can add in the max adapter, and that's what this looks like. And basically, you connect that into the USB-C into the front. This is the Cat 12 version. There's multiple ones of that. An Android device will work. An iPhone will not at this time. I hope that that changes. That's something I needed. But as I got to thinking about this for my relative, I was like, okay, what we can do is go to Starlink and buy the optional Ethernet adapter that Starlink sells. It's $25. We get this. Now you have Starlink running in to this unit, the B1, and then we can plug the NAS in, computer in. They're using three of the connections already. And then if you want to expand on the WAN side, you can. Now you have the two WAN connections on the back, but when you buy this unit, you get this Prime Care package, premium, I guess it's Prime Support, premium support. And with this Prime package, you get the ability to take one of those LAN connections and turn it into a WAN connection. And so that would be three. And with the USB-C on the front and a max adapter, then that's four. But there's even more expandability here. And this is really the key point. When you look at this unit, you might look at this and say, it doesn't really look that special. I mean, other Wi-Fi access points have multiple antennas. Some have way more than two. And this has just four. Some have more than that on the LAN connections. They may only have one WAN, but hey, you know, it's not about that. Okay. It's about what Peplink brings within the firmware and the software. So there are so many cool things that I could talk about. But I'll just mention that there are enterprise things that it's putting in this small to home office unit. And, you know, this unit is really a replacement for what they called the Surf Soho series. And those models, it was before my time. I don't know a lot about Peplink previous to about 2 years ago. I'm just getting familiar with it myself. But basically, my understanding is this has the features of those Soho models, plus the best features of the Balance 20 model. And every device is going to come with these advanced features and multiple WAN capabilities that include the Peplink stuff. Now, the Peplink stuff would be the Peplink Fusion bonding, the WAN smoothing, the relay capability. So let's say you were taking this on the road and you had something like a Peplink router in your house, but you took this on the road and you try to stream something from a streaming provider and they go, oh, no, you can't do that because you're not coming from your main IP address and you're coming through some weird VPN or something. We're not going to allow you to stream. We don't know if it's you. You can relay this traffic so that it looks like you're coming from that IP address and stream just fine. It just solves a lot of different problems being able to do these things. You also have this Wi-Fi over WAN capability. So that's another way to get an additional resilience to your WAN. Peplink, from an enterprise perspective, they are so masterful on the WAN connectivity. That's where they really shine. Although they're not doing too bad in the LAN side either. We're going to be talking about a switch that I'm replacing a Cisco switch with soon. And there's really some great capabilities there. But this really is a perfect companion to anybody who has Starlink and then wants to add additional redundancy for WAN plus some physical connections into the unit and still get Wi-Fi 6 at a price point that I think most people in the home office can afford. Now, when you start using the Speed Fusion and you want to use like the Speed Fusion VPN and encrypt those traffic, it even though there's gigabit on the device at the hardware level, when you use the VPN, it's going to slow down. Okay. So you're going to have unencrypted, you can have 400 up to 400 megabits per second. But if you're encrypting it, it's 200. Okay. Still really not bad for fully encrypted, tunneled traffic like that. That makes it a lot safer and secure. And for people who are really working now full time from their home office, maybe you've got a business line that you're using for your own, like say your own Xfinity business service, but then you also have something from the company as well, and you're having to pull those both together. Or sometimes you may be using Starlink, but you know it goes down in the evenings or during a bad storm or something, and you need something extra to be able to fail over to or to provide that resilience for. This is a great solution for that. And then once you are ready to add or want to expand into a 5G LTE situation, you can add that through the USB-C. Look at the firmware capabilities inside of what Peplink offers to all of these models, this and up. It's there, and I think it's worth a look. Where I get my stuff from is from buypeplink.com, and I'll show you that site right now. This is actually where I bought my unit from. And of course, the people at West Networks, they are my friends. So I appreciate them and I do recommend them. And because I'm affiliated with them, if you use my PERFTOUR code when you check out, PERFTOUR, then West Networks is going to do something really special for you. There's also the possibility that if you're watching this during the campaign that they have right now, where you can add a max adapter to this unit, you can get a really good price on it. So I recommend going to buypeplink.com, use perftour.com. If you call West Networks from the site, you can call their number and you talk to one of their reps, make sure you tell them that their partner Scott Moore is recommending this. Again, I bought this unit with my own money. This is not something that West Networks gave me. I'm just doing an attaboy for them. So do that today and tell them that Scott sent you. And let me know what happens if you get it and you get it hooked up and how it's working for you and the capabilities that you see. Take some time and look at the other videos that are on YouTube. I know that West Networks has their own unboxing of this unit, and there are a few other YouTube videos out there on it where they describe it in probably a lot more detail than me, and these are really experienced Peplink users. But I just thought this as a casual user of it on my own, and being fairly new to the product line, I thought this would just be a fresh take for you to check out. So appreciate it. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you on the next SMC Journal podcast. This is Scott Moore saying thanks. Bye-bye.